dakika istemiş. Buralarımız.
Still alive. Shit.
Have you been sleeping all right?
I saw a dead man. His lips were green. He'd been eating grass, do you see? Because he was starving. We're not cows, we can't eat grass.
My savior! Here, I've been cooking. Taste this. What you think? Yummy, isn't it?
wonder if there's some sort of blight that's turning all the vegetables bad. At least we have our memories, right?
If you find fresh food, don't try to hoard it. The blight turns things rotten sooner than you think. You can't have our water. I see you, you murderer! To eat it.
It could be worse, I think.
Never thought it would come to this, did we?
I've been looking for one of those.
sleep, the poor man's dinner.
Vanilla, you know it doesn't work for you. How could you forget that?
Lovely day for it. Unfortunately, the bridge is not open at this time. It was working just a minute ago, but the door is broken again. You'll have to wait until it's up again.
Do you ever let anybody in?
Oh, yes. There's someone in there now.
And in the past month?
Well, in the past month. Ah! There's a chap in there right now.
You don't really want anyone back from the Garden District, do you?
Well, my wastrel friend. No one goes off their joy, can actually take joy. I mean, would you? Everybody feels better if that door stays broken. You, us, everybody.
Well, Constable Wright, I suppose now I can tell Central why the bridge keeps breaking down.
Central?
Ever seen one of these?
Oh, bugger me. You're not some sort of undercover bridge inspector.
This device detects structural irregularities using shortwave radar. But I don't think it will show me the real problem, will it, Constable Wright?
Look, sir, you can fix that door, but them wastrels still ain't gonna take their joy. It makes them see eyes everywhere.
That's not for you to decide, is it?
No, sir.
The maintenance hatch is that way, sir. I'd be grateful if you forgot this conversation ever happened.
Maybe I will. Maybe I won't. From Central, I'd have the card, wouldn't I? There is another way, though, isn't there?
Please take a number and sit down.
There's nobody else here.
Please take a number and sit down.
Just resting my feet.
Number two. Now serving number two. Welcome to the rehabilitation center.
Actually, I'm just a sort of undercover bridge inspector from Central. See this device? It detects structural...
Then you should have no trouble passing the test, should you? Please head through the door there and begin your rehabilitation.
Deposit your personal belongings into this box, retaining only your clothes. Please continue to the decontamination room. Please discard your clothes. Don't worry, you will be provided with new, proper clothes after decontamination.
Make thee mighty yet.
Congratulations! Congratulations, you have been decontaminated. Please proceed to the next room and obtain fresh, new, proper, clean clothes.
I hope she's not watching and judging.
On you. Please enjoy this refreshing scent of country flowers.
Is that licorice? Why licorice?
Get ready for the most important moment in your rehabilitation. Please take your favorite flavor of joy. Vanilla, chocolate, or strawberry.
I must insist that you not traverse the beams of the joy detector without taking your joy, sir.
Oh, damn it! They were serious about taking my joy, weren't they? Lovely day for it.
Right-o!
Right as rain, sir. Right as rain.
We're life for noise. Pop a joy. Lovely day for it.
What?
All right.
Lovely day for it.
Please head into the theatre and take a seat. Excellent. Sit tight and enjoy the show.
And now it's time for the Uncle Jack Etiquette Minute. You may be wondering, how can I fit in better in Howland Village? Well, it's easy. To get along, go along. If someone tells you it's a lovely day, agree with them. Because of course, it's always a lovely day in Howland Village, so don't be afraid of talking to people first. They'll appreciate it. Now, I'm assuming, of course, that you're decently dressed. Huh? Clothes make the man, eh? Indeed, naked people have almost no influence at all in society. And don't dress in rags either, or people might think you're a wastrel. Now, what should you do if people are staring at you? Maybe they're asking you if you remember to take your joy. Who cares? Just pop another, and they'll congratulate you and go on about their day. And if things seem to be getting a bit hectic, remember, you can always sit on a bench, relax, and open the Hamnan or Quran. Take a load off. No one will bother you when you're sitting on a bench. Unless you've made them very angry. Well, or, I don't know, watch Jack Worthing on television. I hear he's very good. Well, I'm afraid we've come to the end of our time. Tune in tomorrow for another Etiquette Minute with Jack Worthing. That's me.
Isn't Uncle Jack wonderful? Now, please proceed to the third floor, where you will be tested on what you've just relearned.
Just a friendly reminder. Uncle Jack don't mention it, but a word to the wise. Proper decent people don't like people what is running, jumping, crouching, spying, sneaking, breaking or entering. Such like behaviours is what we associate with downers. Avoid them and we shan't have disagreements.
Bouquet. They do so love flowers. Oh dear. smell it right away. And they'll give you a quick injection to make your day a lovely one. Dr. Byron, what is your question?
What happens when you take too much joy? A. You can't find your own house. B. Who cares? C. Please, God, make them stop staring.
That's right. Clear one. It hardly matters. You might lose a few hours, but sooner or later, you'll find yourself on a bench. No worse for the wear. Oh, clear two. Today is just not your day, is it? But you can always come back for a seventh try. And that concludes this episode of Oh Behave. I hope you made it to the village. If you didn't, remember, we're always happy to give you another shot if you're willing to behave like a decent citizen. Of course we are. Here in Hamlin Village, we're always happy.
Well, that's a relief.
Welcome, welcome, welcome. It's time to play Oh Behave, the game where you show that you're ready to come back to Hamlin Village and behave like a proper, decent citizen.
What the hell? I passed the test. Oh, for heaven's sake, I'm not going to do this again. How do I get out of here?
Are you ready to behave? Now, our five guest questioners are going to ask you one question each. All you have to do is show us that you understand how to behave yourself in Wellington Wells. Mr. Cashier, what question do you have for our prodigal son or daughter?
If you want to fit in, you should. A. Say hello to everyone you meet, like how you do. B. Visit people's houses, whether they're there or not. C. The eyes! The eyes!
Yes, that's right. It never hurts to say hello to people. Player two, I'm afraid the eyes, was not the right answer. Mrs. Browning, what would you like to know?
If you realise you're wearing rags, should you A. pop a joy, B. put on proper clothes for God's sake, and why not pop a joy, C. why does everything have eyes?
Thank you.
May I express my delight that you passed the examination, sir? We've not had as many as we'd hoped, sir. Not as many at all. And yet, they say the unexamined life is not worth living. Well, sir, welcome back. Oh, and in case your rustication has been of long duration, please bear in mind there is now a nocturnal curfew. Best be indoors after nightfall, sir.
Better, thanks.
Isn't this wonderful?
Oh, I can't remember the last time someone came through.
Welcome back to civilization.
Should clear up soon, I imagine. From here, I've got to get to St. George's home and then into the parade. Except that I need a letter of transit to get into the parade, like the one I left on my desk in the parade. How do I get a new one? Wait, the old government printing office was on Maidenhole. Maybe I can break in and steal some blanks. Lovely weather.
Lovely day for it.
Nothing but blue skies.
Did you hear? The circus is coming to town.
Well, the sun seems to be going down, so it's time for all good citizens to go home and go to bed. You don't want to be out at night, do you?
Guys, well, I suppose there are more lingering ways to go. Sloshy. Good place for giant octopi.
half teaspoon of salt, 6 teaspoons of sugar, and a little bit of mashed banana in each quart of water. But if you don't have sugar or banana, and who does, the salt's important.
Find the switch again. I'm in business.
when he woke up, he realized it had all just been a bad dream. There's no place like home. There's no place like home. There's no place like home. I'd really love to know why that particular bin smells of cheese.
from?
Before we begin, please listen to a personal message for our prudent friend. The fox is in the henhouse. The fox is in the henhouse.
Who's our prudent friend?
If some scientist had told me Percy was actually from Mars, I'm not sure I'd have disbelieved him.
They're off. These days, I really ought to explore those caves.
Lovely day for it.
I'm so looking forward to the Battle of Flowers. Aren't you?
What can I do you for today? I've got stuff you don't even know you want.
That would come in handy.
Wise man, wise man. A word to the efficient is sufficient. Know what I mean?
Lovely day for it.
Right as rain, right as rain.
your joy immediately.
Lovely day for it.
I got a new compliment machine. It's so clever. Ah, oh, that's a shame, that is. I told you to leave the moon juice alone, Eddie. What were you thinking? Going near a spanker like that. You never had the common sense that God gave an ordinary bowl of porridge, did you? What am I supposed to tell Sarah, then? Can't exactly tell her you died heroically in the line of duty, can I? Wish you'd join the force with me. What a shame. What a shame.
Thank God for the spankers, right? We can't have downers breaking the pumps anytime they want a bucket of moon juice.
What would Eddie need motoline for, anyway?
Maybe he had an hobby.
What? He was using it to power a set of model trains? Nah, that's not like Eddie.
Oh, no.
Oh, he had a sort of aversion to details.
Maybe he was setting rat traps in the sewers. You'd need a torch for that.
Yeah. Traps require long-term planning. To which he also had a sort of aversion.
Well, he wasn't bloody drinking it, was he? What are you getting at?
I wonder if Lionel Cashier is dealing in contraband motorline.
You might be right. Maybe we should pay him a call.
I'm just glad the spanker didn't spark up the motorline. Can you imagine? With half the fire department off on holiday.
He had a short spike. He could have disarmed the trap. Why didn't he?
Oh, of course. Joy makes you forget.
Smells like something burned down. bloody hell. Oh, you can smell the fog from here. The fog seems smokier. Oh, that's a real nasty piece of super, isn't it? Joy detector. I'd better take my joy.
For a minute there, I thought I'd have to do my job.
What's going on there? The bobbies won't like it if I get too close to that. Unless I look like a council worker, I suppose.
I wouldn't get too close to that. You're liable to get quite a shock.
What's gone wrong here, Constable?
What's gone wrong, sir? Is a complete lack of preventative maintenance. council workers don't test the poppers anymore. They don't even see them until something electronic goes tits up. Just lucky one of the lads wasn't in there when it decided to become a spanker.
So you're waiting for a council worker?
I'm not holding my breath. But I hope one comes soon, because I got places to be.
I wonder how I can get a boiler suit.
Well, nice of you to drop by. It's all yours. You know, if one of these goes off while one of the lads is in it, we will have words, you and I.
I wonder if it was some sort of power surge. Hang on, I could induce a power surge if I can rig up a capacitor of some sort.
Thank you.
Who's working up here? Munchkins?
That's an awful lot of bobbies.
There you are.
Lovely day for it.
Lovely weather.
Right as rain, right as rain.
All right.
All right. Your game, then. For a minute there, stop making me nervous. Lovely day for it.
Stuff. You better throw something away before something starts chasing you. Maybe if I hadn't smoked in high school, I could carry a bit more. Looks like the old printing office is pretty well buttoned up. I wonder if there's a way in the back.
Didn't see you at the pub.
You know, why spin up?
Odd. Why are there peepers patrolling the park? I should snoop around a bit.
Ralph, you're not a bloody mule. Pick what you can carry easily.
Move along, please. What's done is done. Nothing to see here. Past is history. Now, now, mind your own business. Yesterday is no place to live.
What happened to him?
Well, I'm not quite sure. He's been a solid citizen long as I've been on this beat. Then today he's gone on about leaving Amlin, waving around a suitcase like a rotten downer.
Well, we can't have that.
Don't know where he thought he was going. Nobody goes to the Garden District, don't have to.
Maybe he had relatives across the bridge.
That's right. There's been an outbreak of relatives across the bridge.
Has there been an outbreak of downers?
No. Of course not. There's nothing to worry about.
Well, that's a relief.
I'm sure the joy is just as good as it's ever been. Each batch just gets better and better. You keep taking it. It'll take care of you.
This is for you.
better, thanks.
Right as rain, sir. Right as rain. Oi! Get out of there!
There!
You're
the
okay.
One with blood on his hands!
Don't be a drag, baby!
I know they did.
Quite a burning thirst, Doug.
No stakes in my garden.
Last one smiling is a rotten egg.
There's the one that did it.
The killer's right there.
Get him.
To sleep, perchance to dream.
How can I help you?
There you are.
Righto.
Lionel Cashier. Nice to see the old shop still running.
As long as the old ticker's going. Come to buy or come to sell? Arthur, you're an ingenious sort of fellow. I've a buyer, a collector, who likes to collect golden records. Now, I happen to know where there's three of them out in the garden district. If you'd go get them for me, I'd make it worth your while.
Why don't you get them?
Go to the garden district? Oh, of course, there's nothing I'd like better. Go out there, see the old streets, but I'm so busy with the shop and all, I can hardly step out for Simon Says. And you know how people are when you miss a village activity. No, here's a map for you. Best if you do it.
Lovely day for it.
Come on, you pack rat. You can't take all this with you.
Mm-hmm.
I appreciate your custom. I hope to see you again soon.
Hurt yourself.
I thought I was going to have to call a bomb. Bobby.
Já chega por hoje. Amanhã mais. Thanks for watching. Até logo. Boas noites.